This time, y has multiple terms. Y equals 1 over 3 x to the third plus 5 times square root x minus 7. You have three terms in total. From the rule, the sum and the difference rule of the derivative, you do term by term. You find the derivative of each term and then add them or subtract them depends on operator that you have. For this problem, you have three terms. Do one term at a time. So y prime, this step, I'm going to do the derivative. The first term has the coefficient 1 over 3. And what is the derivative of x to the third? The power is 3. 3 times x to the 3 minus 1. Okay, I do one at a time. And the second term, 5 as a coefficient, yes, and the square root x, we have to write it as a power. We call the square root is the power 1/2. Now, for the derivative, the I is 1/2. 1/2 is the coefficient. And the new power or the derivative power going to be 1/2 minus 1. And the last term, this is the constant term. Recall the constant term, the derivative is 0. Okay. We got the detail work done. Next, we just clean up each term to get the nice result. For the first one, 3 and 3 reduce, and then x to the power 3 minus 1 becomes x to the second. Next term, 5 times 1/2 becomes 5 over 2. X to the power negative 1 over 2 and minus 0. Or you can write the answer in the positive power term as x to the second plus 5 over 2 times 1 over x to the second, no, the x to the 1/2, sorry. And then the x to the 1/2, that is the same as square root. So I'm going to put here or equals x to the second plus 5 over 2 times square root x. So you have the three versions of the answer, either one. When you answer in the Hox learning, you just look at the instruction. Keep in mind, if you don't follow the instruction or you don't input the same format, you will not get the credit. Otherwise, you have to email me, and if they are equivalent and it's okay enough, so I will adjust the score for you. Okay, so this A, B, C, D, E, F, and then the last one, I'm gonna add another slide here. This one has, we're gonna do more work. For part G, the y equals the product of x squared plus 1 quantity and the 2 minus x quantity. We do not have the product rule at this point, but eventually we will. So what we can do, we're going to expand or multiply these two products, these two factors. So do it as you normally do with the way that you multiply the two binomials or multiply polynomial and polynomial, or use the term FOIA that you are familiar with, okay? X squared times 2, so 2x squared. X squared times negative x, that's negative x to the third power. 1 times 2, that's 2. 1 times negative x, that's negative x. If you recall the FOIL technique, F-O-I-L, first and first, outer and outer, inner and inner, last and last, you will get four terms. And then look whether you have light terms to simplify. For this case, you do not have light terms because the power 2, power 3, no power, and power 1, no light terms to simplify further. So your Y function is ready for the next step, which is the step that we're gonna find the derivative. Okay, so y prime, again, we have four terms. We're gonna have four derivatives from each term, one derivative from each term. The first term, the coefficient 2, and the derivative of x squared, the power 2, gonna be 2 coefficient, and then multiply by x to the 2 minus 1. And the next, no coefficient, for the x to the third, we have 3. Times x to the 3 minus 1. For the derivative of 2, this is a constant. We're going to get derivative 0. And the last one, the derivative of, recall for the y equals mx plus b, the m is the slope. which is the y prime, and that apply to y equals x. So then the y prime equals x, or equals one. Sorry, equals one. So in this case, the derivative is going to be one with a negative sign in the front. Now, what we can do more, just to simplify, 2 times 2, that's 4. X to the power 2 minus 1 becomes x to the first power minus 3 times x to the second, omit 0, and then minus 1.